Everybody loves shoulders. Trust me, I do too. That lighting wasn't good. Let me try this right here. Trust me, I do too.
Skinny bitch.
It's so crazy how people nowadays can judge you based off of your physique. For men, when a female looks at you, do they think, oh, I want a guy with small shoulders, I want a blocky waist, I want skinny legs? I guarantee you right now, they do not say that shit. Life could be a dream. Hey, maybe some do, maybe that's your type, I'm not, whatever. But a lot of people do not focus on the big important step, and that is life could be a dream. Lateral raises. I'm telling y'all right now, ever since I started doing this exercise, like, straight up, nothing has happened. Like, bro, straight up, nothing has happened because, yeah, going to the gym doesn't get you women, so I'm sorry, folks. I'm gonna show you guys how you could get the physical appearance that a female might typically like, and that's with one exercise. You heard it here, folks, one exercise. Like, if you're in 2023 right now, think about it. If you're not doing lateral raises, you guys are missing out. And you know, I'm not saying like if you don't work out, this is the only exercise you need. Obviously, you should still be doing legs. You should still be doing chest. You should still be doing back. But this exercise is going to change your physique in such a big way. Because when you take off your pump cover, the first thing that people are going to look at is number one, like being your arms, but your shoulders. Your shoulders are so crucial for having that V-taper aesthetic physique. If you guys are wanting 3D delts, kind of like this, I'm not saying like my shoulders are massive. They're not exactly the biggest part of my body. Hey, yo, hang on.
That's tough. They got you locked up for life, my boy. The hell wrong with you? Hey, yo!
But I'm telling you guys right now, ever since I started hitting shoulders, specifically side delts, I've been seeing a big confidence increase when I'm at the gym, when I'm taking off like the pump covers, when I'm doing all that. So I'm telling y'all right now, make sure you do your lateral raises. But I'm not just gonna end off the video here. I'm gonna show you guys how to do lateral raises, and I'm gonna be showing you guys different ways to do lateral raises. So if one way doesn't work for you, you can try this way. Let's just get into it. Now, if y'all are younger watching this video right now, and you guys are like not into the gym yet, you came across this video, I'm not saying just do lateral raises, because obviously doing like full upper body, full lower body is important, but a lot of people miss out on the important things. They think just doing bench press or just doing squat is important. But targeting the smaller muscle groups is just as important, guys. And when I say it, I really mean it. I went from looking like this to looking like this. And I'm like,
skinny bitch.
Bro. Now, typically when I do my side delt raises or my lateral raises, people call it, you gotta make sure you have proper form first. So what I like doing when I'm doing standing lateral raises, I do a whole like mix of lateral raises, but when I do specifically standing, I like to go like this. Put the whatever weight you have, I'm just using 2.5s for example, put it like on your thighs or like on your quads, kind of bend down a little bit.
What do you mean by that?
And what you wanna do is you wanna make sure when you go up, you kind of bend your elbows a little bit. Not like a 90 degree and you go like this. You don't wanna do that. That'll look stupid in the gym. Do not do that. But when you attempt your first lateral raise, what you wanna do is you kinda wanna bring your elbow up and kinda crank it back. But at the same time, keep your posture nice and straight. And make sure you're leaning over to the point where your lateral head, which is right here, is facing against gravity, and you're pulling it where your side delt muscle is like facing upwards, not sideways like this, upwards. That is gonna give you the most growth in your side delt, hands down. But standing isn't the only option, and sometimes it doesn't work for most people. Most people like me, unfortunately. And that's why there's other options out there, guys. This guy right here that I'm about to show you has really improved my mind muscle connection with my shoulders, specifically my side delts. Now, what you need for this, a lot of people don't have it, so you can use honestly anything, just something you can put your hand on and something that you're stabilized with and doesn't move around. But what you wanna do is grab any weight. I'm just using this, for example, 2.5. Now, what you wanna do is go on the bench, place like your arm, like your forearm on the pad. Grab whatever weight you have right here in your left hand, right hand, whatever, and make sure you kind of press down on your side delt muscle while you do your lateral raise. Now, something that actually helps me is putting my opposite leg that I'm using on my arm. So if I'm using my left arm, it would be my right leg, is putting that in front of like my body. So I'll try to angle it down a little bit so you see it like that right there. Put the right leg in front, and then you, fuck, I can't adjust my camera. Then you use your left arm to do your lateral raise. So basically, what you wanna do is just do a normal lateral raise, kinda bend over a little bit, put your weight on your forearm and make sure to push down on your side delt to get that my muscle connection going. Maybe tap it a little bit and then just do a lateral raise. Now this, ever since I started doing it, has improved my side delt growth quite a bit. And the reason for that is because I actually lacked shoulder my muscle connection quite a bit. And I never knew why, but for some reason, ever since I started doing this trick where you like hold down on your side delt while doing it, it really helps. And some of you guys may or may not know, some of you guys may or may not have gym bros, but when a gym bro is helping you get those final reps, you can feel it just burning in your shoulders. That feels really good, but sometimes you don't always have gym bros to help you out. So this is really good for when you're solo, but I'm not just gonna end off on two workouts. I got another damn workout for y'all. Now, if y'all are on the slower side, bear with me. Now, what you wanna do is you wanna grab two weights for both of your hands. I'm gonna use 2.5s, for example. Now, what you wanna do is you wanna have a bench for this or something you can stabilize yourself on. Put your chest against the pad or whatever you got. And now what you wanna do is kinda keep your chest up, roll your shoulders back, and just begin the lateral raise. Like straight up, it's that simple. It's not rocket science, people. This is hands down one of the easiest lateral raise techniques that you can use. I use this for a very long time. It actually really helps you not to ego lift. A lot of people, when they're doing the lateral raises, they like swing it up a lot. You don't wanna do that a whole ton. So this is why I actually really love this exercise, including the last one. But you keep your chest up against the pad so you can't really swing it as much. You can still get a little like swing with it, but not as much as when you're standing. But the trick is go lightweight and just do a lateral raise. Make sure to keep the shoulders rolled back and just get a sick ass pump, boys. Oh my God, bro. I looked unnatty as shit for a second. I'm not even gonna lie to you guys. I literally just got the fattest pump off of that. If you guys wanna learn how to get an easy pump, go on the toilet and just try to take a shit. Like, I swear to God, it's the best pump ever. Obviously, guys, I'm kidding.
Stop the cap.
But basically, we got a little shoulder workout ahead of us. We're gonna be just hitting side delts, actually. We might throw a little triceps in there, too. We're not gonna go too crazy because we're really sore from my push day yesterday. But the plan is to hit some side delts. And we're probably gonna just do two exercises for it, and we might run some jump rope, and we're gonna call it. Your boy's trying to get better at jump rope, you know? We're trying to mix your new things. Your boy's an adventurous man. That's all I gotta say. Oh no! All right, boys, now comes the segment where we just spam the fuck out of lateral raises, so let's run it. Pretty close to fully pumped in the shoulder department, but I feel like we're missing one thing. Oh yeah, that's posing. When I walk on by, girls be looking like damn fly. God damn. I'm into the beat, walking down the street and my new the freak, yeah. This is how I roll, animal print pants out of control. It's Red Bull with the big ass fro, and like Bruce Lee, I got the clout, yeah. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. I work out. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. I work out. When I walk in the spot, yeah, this is what I see. Everybody stops and is staring at me. I got passion in my pants and I ain't afraid to show it. Show it, show it, show it. I'm sexy and I know it. Alright guys, I'm not even joking with y'all. I was out here for 30 minutes probably posing, and yeah, the pump is officially gone. So we were out here for a fat minute, so that's all. I just gotta throw that out there, okay? You're not actually a real gym bro if you don't pose. Y'all gotta be posing, because when you're done with your workout, what are you gonna do, just go home? Now you gotta check out what you're building, bro. Come on, do better, do better. But guys, that's gonna about do it for today's video. I hope y'all enjoyed. It was just a little quick one, a little quickie, you know what I'm saying? But anyways, guys, hope y'all enjoy. Make sure to leave a like, and if you guys wanna use top of the line supplements, make sure to check out the links in the description. Also for clothing in the gym, Iron Ground Athletics, definitely recommend checking them out. Your boy's getting really fat. As soon as we get like our shoulders probably a little bigger and we're back up to where we used to be, may drop down to maintenance calories once again, because we are getting very chubby down there. Hey, bad days come and go, man. But you cannot let the bad days define who you are. You can't let it determine your success. One thing that I always like to keep in the back of my mind is if you truly wanted it bad enough, you would do anything it takes to get where you want to be. Bad days don't just happen for no reason. there's a meaning behind it. And that meaning is to just shape you into the person that you are meant to be. And if you feel like no one's responding to you, if you feel like nothing's helping, if you feel like no one is going to help you, you have to remember that it's all test, people. If you truly wanted it bad enough, you would get it. And yeah, just like and subscribe.